Hi, everyone. I'm Kelly Peppers, the CEO of Colossal Media. Thank you for joining us. Today, we're going to have a discussion with Lauren and Josh from Stella Artois and Zelle to talk about the behind the scenes at their brands right now during the COVID-19 situation that clearly is changing everything everywhere. So I'm going to let them introduce themselves. I'm going to pass the mic over to my friend Josh first. Josh, talk to us.
All right. Thanks a bunch, Kelly. I'm Josh Fajardo. I lead paid media strategy and partnerships at Early Morning for the brand Zelle. We focus in peer-to-peer money transfers, and you can find us in your bank app, most likely. And yeah, that's me in a nutshell.
So now let's get to lovely Lauren. Lauren, talk to me. Tell me all about yourself.
My name is Lauren. I work at Anheuser-Busch and lead communications for the Stella Artois team. So, Belgian import beer, and I've been in this position for just around 2 years and at AB for around 3.
Okay, so let's get right into it. I'm sure all of our brains are just kind of like just full of clutter of ideas because whether it's you on your own accord or your boss asking you to innovate or your boss's boss asking you to totally pivot, right now it's all about ideas. Can you share with us any sort of new ideas that are taking place over at Zelle to try to react to everything that's taking place?
Yes. Obviously, we're living in a very tricky time. And we've always been that brand that wants to be out there and wants to facilitate, you know, people sending each other money. And right now it obviously seems the most timely with people trying to help out their friends, their neighbors, and families. So right now what we're doing is trying to lean more into how can we be the mechanism. What we're trying to do is try to lean into opportunities where we can, you know, be a part of that dialogue, whether that's, you know, working with certain personalities to say like, hey, as you help your community, like if we have someone who's like helping, you know, friends and family with rent in New Orleans, like we have a way for you to get them that money quickly, fast, you know, easy, safely, that sort of thing. So I think for us, it's really been leading into the functionality of what we do above all else. It's been a little bit of a shift in which there's been a greater emphasis for that. Because as a new brand, we're still very much trying to get our name out there and have people understand that like Zelle is like a thing that exists in your bank app most likely, but we still need to do the job of like educating people of what we are, where we are. And now at the same time, you know, actually trying to put into practice like ways that we can actually get more folks, high profile folks, or just let people know, like you can use us right now and it's going to be helpful.
Hey, Lauren, how about over at Stella Artois? What's some big ideas brewing right now?
So, you know, I think an interesting fact about Stella is that we are a brand that was really born in the on-premise and really does have a stronghold in the on-premise, so bars and restaurants. And so obviously, you know, with bars and restaurants and the folks who work in that industry being so severely impacted, we felt like we really had a role to play in helping that industry. And so we've started a idea called Sessions at Home, Stella Artois Sessions at Home, where we have partnered with some big chef names and then have also worked with the James Beard Foundation to find some chefs in our favorite, in a few of our favorite cities. And they join us around 3 times a week to help folks at home kind of, you know, create those restaurant worthy restaurant style meals for themselves. So, you know, it gives the people who drive our business, these chefs and the restaurants that they own, a platform to continue doing what they love. It gives our consumers, you know, a way to bring some spice into their life, quite literally, and then learn some awesome recipes. And then our call to action for these consumers and our ask is, you know, while you're cooking at home, we all know that hopefully there's a day when we return to the restaurants and we're really hoping that those restaurants are still here for us. So we ask consumers to go to Help Main Street, which is a really awesome website that basically any bar or restaurant can sign up for. And there consumers can buy gift cards for themselves or for the future. So we're calling it reserving a table for tomorrow, all in the hopes that, you know, we can both help the chefs of our favorite restaurants as well as help the consumers at home, and then make sure that those restaurants are still there for everyone on the other side of this thing. So Stella Sessions at Home has been running for about a month now, and we've seen really great results. And we've seen that the traffic to help Main Street, most importantly, has been, you know, increased tenfold, which just makes us really happy and hopeful that the bars and restaurants that mean so much to us and obviously our consumers will still be there on the other side.
So it sounds like both Zelle and Stella Artois have fantastic ideas. Now, my next question is, how have you pivoted your marketing and advertising to make sure everybody knows about these ideas and make sure everyone's using your product or buying your beer? So how has your marketing and advertising changed right now?
You know, I think that in regards to the Stella Sessions at Home idea, but really all of the ideas, and there are tons being cooked right now. Ironically, while the whole world has changed and while consumers have changed and when, you know, occasions for drinking beer have changed, the one thing that hasn't changed is, you know, really our job as a brand, which is to bring messages and products that are super relevant to consumers. So it's kind of just put the onus back on us to say, let's make sure that everything we're putting out there is extremely relevant, and that it's adjusted to the consumers in the need states and, you know, the lifestyle and the mental states that they're experiencing right now. So, you know, I think the great thing is that we've realized through this all that Stella Artois' brand purpose of helping people savor life together is actually something that, you know, makes a ton of sense in a non-COVID world and actually makes a hell of a lot of sense even in a COVID world. So it's just a matter of like, how do we take that core message and really make sure that it comes through in a way that consumers nod and understand like why Stella can still authentically play a role in their life today.
Josh, how about you guys over there at Zelle? What have you had to change for your marketing and your advertising?
I echo a lot of the points that Lauren made. I'll take it a little bit different. I think one thing that we've had to be all cognizant of as marketers is tonality. To your point about, you know, seeing some ads that you don't find necessarily relevant right now, I think for us, we often put ourselves out there in the space that's like trying to be entertaining, quirky, but for us, a big change has been like, how do we appear in the marketplace with a service and something that we do know will be helpful for folks, but dial it back or at least have like a more mindful shift in tone in terms of like how we want people to even enjoy the messaging that we're putting out there in the space. So I think that's become one of the big things. And, you know, I know that there's a lot of brands out there right now who are being very mindful in the communications around what's happening in communities and that heartfelt tone. But I think that oftentimes starts to feel a little bit one note too. So to Lauren's point about authenticity, like, yes, acknowledge that things are happening and our society is changing and adapting to what a new normal is. Stay true to yourself and put yourself out there in a way that's going to be authentic and hopefully helpful to folks, whether that's a experience at home, you know, making dinner, or whether that's like making sure that you feel good that your loved ones are getting the money that you want to get to them. So I think tonality is a really big deal right now, and that's something that we're trying to be really cognizant of.
Let's take you to a question that really pertains to probably most of the people who are watching this video right now. Okay, so Zelle and Stella Artois both have done out-of-home advertising in the past. You've done it with us at Colossal. I'm sure you've done it in a lot of other different mediums as well. What do you like about ad of home? Josh, this one goes to you first.
Yeah. Anecdotally, I think it's absolutely fantastic when I have folks in my life, friends, family, seeing us out there, like as they're going to a bar, as they're going shopping, and like, you all have that great placement in Williamsburg. I think it's on the corner of Wife and Grand, in which you kind of wrap that corner. And for us to put like a really, I guess, relevant message to Williamsburg and that corner, and then have folks like take pictures of it, send it to me, and just be like, this thing is crazy. That to me is one of my favorite bits about out of home, because it's, you know, everyone says it, like, unlike digital, I can't ad block it. I mean, I could kind of do that thing, but at the same time, you know, I think that's pretty much an easy answer. So I would say that that's absolutely a favorite, because you get everyone's story and it's kind of like, oh, great. I don't even have to ask. You experience my brand. You experience it out in the wild, and then I'm getting like a quirky anecdote. So that to me, I find fulfilling.
Lauren, how about you? What do you love about out of home in the past? Why was it something that was effective for you?
Well, Josh stole my answer, so I will build upon his a bit. But, you know, I think to build, one of my favorite things is just, I think in life, if you're experiencing an out of home, it probably means that you're not looking down at your phone, which is kind of one of those rare moments. So I totally just, you know, I think that whether it's on a highway and you're kind of zoning out and you're taking that moment to yourself, or you're walking down the street in Williamsburg and you happen to see the Zelle out of home, I think it actually means you're up, you're looking around. And actually, I do think that because of that, it is one of the most, the pieces of advertising that you see and you remember, because you were in a state of mind where you were set up to remember something and take in a new moment or a new message. So I think for me, you know, especially with a lot of the colossal out of homes that we've done with you guys, they're beautiful, they're big, they're ground level. And so you really, you take it in a way that you can't necessarily take in a lot of, you know, short social 6-second advertisements that you just experience on your thumb for a second.
Agree. So, okay. So now a big question, and nobody watching this will hold you to it. Given everything that's going on, do you intend to spend more or less? And I'll preface that by saying that oftentimes during crisis, people want to hear more from brands. They want to hear how you feel, what's your message, what's your big point that you're trying to make. And so going quiet may not be the best approach. So given that, do you guys intend on spending more, less, not sure yet? How are you feeling over there about your spends?
We are very privileged at Anheuser-Busch. As you mentioned before, Kelly, people are drinking even more. And so we do have the ability to continue putting out our message. I think that ultimately the challenge was given out to the brands, Stella, as well as the other beers within our portfolio. They said, again, if you can bring me a message that's relevant, we will look for the money. So it's a challenge to the brand teams to say, you know, based on what my brand stands for, what am I going to do about this? And how much does that cost? And the reality is, some of the advertisements that we've put out in COVID have been cost less than $15,000 to put together and have done better in terms of performance than some of the things that we spend much more on. And so ultimately it's not really, we haven't gone in saying we're going to spend less. We haven't gone in saying we got to pour money into this. It's a, let's figure out what the content is that we need. And then let's figure out, you know, how much money we need to support this properly.
Josh, how about you? More, less, same, not sure.
Well, I think you all nailed it so far. It's refreshing to hear, Lauren, that we both work for brands to where you can have that dialogue, because I think there are probably folks who aren't as fortunate. They can say like, oh man, I have to cut money and I don't have the opportunity to try to win it back or talk through the reasoning as to why my brand needs to be out there in the space right now. And Kelly, you anecdotally said like, oh yeah, like brands feel like, you know, right now might not be the time to go away. And we've seen countless data that really reinforces that, especially with us, where we've been on an upward trajectory. To go dark right now would actually be a really big disservice to our brand. So I think it is kind of scary, because especially when shelter in place orders hit, people are like, well, what's the point of marketing right now? And for us, we've had to make the case of like, right now, oh boy, right now is the time that we do want to be there, knowing that this change in behavior is happening. So I really hope that sales folks don't get demoralized, because the conversations are ongoing. Sure, you know, I may not have the purview of setting a budget that's exactly the same amount as last year, or it might be some percentage less or higher. I don't know that just yet. But at the same time, like, there are dialogues that can help, you know, make the case for us. And you all are very much a big part of that.
What can your at-home vendors and operators, your partners, and also your agency partners do to convince you that spending an ad at home right now is a good idea?
Josh, you want to
talk? Lauren,
yeah, I'm doing so bad as a moderator. Lauren, it's all you, girl.
I'm the first. So, you know, I think ultimately one of the things that we're looking for hasn't necessarily changed just because of COVID. I think that ultimately one of the biggest challenges that we've had on out of home recently is that there are a bunch of touch points that seem to be able to deliver a more personalized message. One that is a little bit more, you could say relevant to a consumer because it's able to, you know, use data sources and whatnot. And so I think that the ask of all of our out of home vendors pre, post, after COVID will forever be, you know, help us make this medium work even harder for us, knowing how much personalization can do in terms of effectiveness. So I think that is, you know, one of the things that we'll always look to Colossal and other out of home vendors to help us with. But I think, you know, in a more COVID specific vein, I think that one of the things I've been thinking about recently as a Manhattan resident is, you know, what is the future of cities and how will that impact, you know, out of home? And I think something I've even been thinking about is, you know, will my friends move out of the city? Will they all get cars and commute in? Will highway billboards now become the hottest piece of out of home inventory? And what does that mean for mass transit? And so just, you know, it's a little bit bigger maybe than even just what the out of home folks would typically help us with, but help us understand like where is humanity, where are people moving and how therefore is that impacting what media they're seeing when and how we can make sure that the message that they're being hit with is appropriate and relevant and as personalized, as I mentioned, as it possibly can be.
Josh.
Yeah.
Talk to me.
I would say what we would look for from our out of home partners and agencies for sure would be an understanding of what's happening on the ground. Like with the inability to travel, to do market tours, that sort of thing, as a national brand, to understand what the actual behaviors are in, say, like Atlanta right now would be really hard for me. As I could read all the news I would want in the Southeast, but, you know, for vendors who, say, has inventory down there, or whether it's Brooklyn, San Francisco, what have you, everyone's mindset is a little bit different. So understanding that, you know, my placements might do a little bit, I don't want to say better, but like might get more eyeballs in a certain market versus another, depending on what the consumer comfort is. Like that, I would say, is a pretty vital piece of information for sure.
But I think ultimately, especially at a big company, you got to get that data, you got to prove your points. And unfortunately, I think in this world, a picture is not worth 1,000 data points. So I would say get us that data and we'll turn it into a pretty chart and then we'll sell it like hell.
That's a good quote. Thanks. I like that. And I want to end on a note that's super hopeful and full of promise. So I want to know, during the time of COVID, what has been a silver lining for you? Hold on, okay? Because I think honesty is the best policy. And my kids are downstairs.
I hear something happening.
What we got? Oh.
Drinking at home. On the job.
I thought you'd never ask. I came prepared.
I mean, nice, I'm going nice. To support us nice. All here and then add a twist of Zelle in there as well.
Oh, home viewers, this was not planned. I swear we're not that smart.
No, it's just. Always have a koozie
cheers,
at all times.
Cheers, you guys. Cheers.
Cheers.
This drink is up.
Linear TV, so I can drink on camera.
Don't judge. So seriously, any other silver linings for you guys besides drinking on the job?
On a serious note, for like 1 second, it's like it's been refreshing to see so much dialogue around like mental health and it's okay not being okay and supporting each other and all that. Like if this crazy pandemic accelerates one thing, like the dialogue around mental health is like one that I think is fantastic. So I'll say that on a serious note. And then, I mean, you all got to experience it firsthand. The amount of quality time that I get with my cat is really through the roof. Like I don't know. She's a handful. Kelly, I don't know how you do it with kids because she's a part of like every call I'm on these days.
Yeah, it's
so
crazy.
So that's very much, it's on the up and up.
The best part about having to go through this is that honestly, I've seen of myself and of my coworkers, some of the most agile, working, quick thinking, impressive, creative ideas. And it really just, you know, it made me really proud of myself. It made me really proud of my team. I think some of the ideas that we've come up with have been some of the coolest things that I've actually worked on since I started a career in the communications world. So I think that, you know, this scrum attitude, this agile work environment, especially at a place like Anheuser-Busch that is massive and matrixed and you know, does take a while to get things through. I think I've seen everyone from the, you know, senior leadership down to, you know, the youngest members of the team, the newest members, just really working together to collaborate and to quickly get things done. And definitely, like, I think all in the name of the consumer and the people at home and the people on the front lines. And so I hope that this agile environment and this super surge of creativity just continues no matter what the world looks like.
Hopefully one day I could see you both in person and thank you more properly. And thank you to everyone who is watching. We hope that we delivered some good content and you learned some new things about how brands are evolving during the time of COVID.
Then I was thinking that at the very end, it seems like it's over, but it's not. And it says behind the scenes, ...
And now the most important question of all. What does out of home mean to you, young lady?
Like taking walks with my family.
That sounds quite lovely. And say you were out of home, taking a walk with your family, and you saw an advertisement for something that you really wanted. What would you do?
I tell my mom to take a picture that when I earn enough money, I'll get it.
Oh, humble young lady. So you're going to earn that money. Mm-hmm. Okay. Very interesting. What is the best advertisement that you've ever seen?
My favorite one was American Girl doll.
We never did that one. Okay, so if anyone out there works for American Girl Doll, this young lady really, really wants you to advertise, particularly on a Colossal Media hand-painted wall. Agree?
Mm-hmm.
Agree. Anything else you want to say?
I want a dog.
I want one too. Hi.
How are you doing, Lauren?
Good, how are you?
Good. My name's Alex. I handle a lot of the tech stuff here at Colossal. So I'm just on for the beginning. And then if you have any questions, you can let me know. I'm based out of Union City, New Jersey.
Nice. I was going to say that looks a little big to be a New York City apartment. Or at least.
Yeah, it's a little, it's my spare bedroom. Yeah.
All right. While they're coming, I'm going to go use the ladies room really quick. If we're ready to have some fun, then I'm prepared. I have two Stellas chilling in the fridge. So if we're ready to have some fun.
I don't want you to be mad at me if at some point it goes in here.
I was going to say, what if Josh was just doing like the top work attire, bottom boxers, and now he's standing up?
Hey, kitty cat, you want to be in a video?
And again, like, just don't, you know, don't take it too serious. Like, don't feel like you have to have a perfect answer. So most importantly, if we screw up, just keep going.